I want to ask you a pretty strange question, but firstly, we need to understand the nature of black holes, massive stars that have stages of lifetime, such as fusion fuel or hydrogen reduction, light pressure and temperature decrease, decrease in internal pressure and compression of the star under the influence of gravity. Supernova. And then, black hole. The weight under compression becomes so tremendous that it falls into a space extremely deeply and forms a black hole. After a black hole is formed, it can grow by absorbing mass from its surroundings. In 1783, geologist John Michell, known as the father of black holes, first described a black hole.
A volume of space where gravity is so strong that nothing, not even light, can escape from it.
He thought that the gravity is so strong that the speed required to overcome it exceeds the speed of light, known as the fastest speed in the universe. But he didn't know where it would lead. A black hole itself is structured in different parts. An accretion disk is a structure that forms around a central object, such as a black hole or a young star, when matter spirals inward due to gravitational forces. It is like a flattened disc-like structure composed of gas, dust, and other material that is being pulled into the center by the strong gravitational pull of the central object. Photon sphere. It is an area where gravity is so dreadful that photons are forced to travel in orbits without a chance to escape the black hole. The event horizon. The point of no return. It is a boundary beyond which any object or information is forever trapped by the devastating gravitational pull of the black hole. And once matter crosses the event horizon, it is thought to be lost forever. According to our current understanding of physics, any information about the matter inside a black hole is inaccessible to observers outside the event horizon. Singularity. The singularity is a place where matter is compressed. The singularity is a place where matter is compressed down to an infinitely tiny point, where the gravitational force is incredibly strong, and the laws of physics, as we currently understand them, are starting to break down. But what if I say that our universe is not alone, and that many scientists think that parallel universes may exist in a black hole?
The most obvious question that you want to ask: can you enter a black hole without a horrible death? Let's take an answer from Stephen Hawking.
If you fall towards a black hole feet first, gravity will pull harder at your feet than your head, because they are nearer the black hole. The result is you'll be stretched out longwise and squashed in sidewise. If the black hole has a mass of a few times our sun, you would be torn apart and made into spaghetti before you reached the horizon. However, if you fell into a much larger black hole with a mass of a million times the sun, you would reach the horizon without difficulty. So if you want to explore the inside of a black hole, choose a big one. There is a black hole of about a million solar masses at the center of our Milky Way galaxy.
Hawking's breakthrough by combined models of general relativity and quantum mechanics revealed that black holes possess a temperature and emit thermal radiation, subsequently known as Hawking radiation, leading to their full eventual evaporation. But in the string theory, everything is made of tiny, one-dimensional vibrating strings that create quarks, electrons, and atoms. This theory suggests that black holes could be fuzzballs without singularities or sharp horizons. If string theory is true, then it resolves the information conservation paradox, as instead of collapsing all of the black hole's mass into a single point, it gets distributed around the ring-like structure of these strings. The firewall paradox arises as a potential obstacle for extracting information from a black hole. The theory proposes that at the event horizon, there should be a fire ring or firewall. The firewall functions as a protective barrier that incinerates any matter or information that approaches and enters the black hole. Nonetheless, fuzzballs align with toy models of idealized black holes with zero temperature. In this scenario, there should be no Hawking radiation, and black holes do not evaporate. But we know what does concern you. What is inside of it? So, a black hole has only three measurements. Mass. By calculating gravitational effect on stars around a black hole, we can measure its mass. The smallest known black hole is only 3 times our sun's mass, while the biggest black hole is 66 billion times the sun's mass. Spin. By measuring the distance between the accretion disk and the black hole, we can understand how fast it spins. The faster it spins, the closer its accretion disk lies to it, like pressing your arms close to the body in figure skating. But hypothetically, when the black hole is spinning too fast, it can lead to a naked singularity. A black hole without an event horizon, where you can see what's inside of it from the outside. But to this day, we haven't found this type of black hole yet, and scientists can't imagine how it would look because it is just a hypothesis. Charge. By the vast amount of charged particles that have fallen into a black hole, it can become negatively or positively charged. A black hole can also be non-charged. Theory suggests that if a black hole is spinning and has a charge, then it will have non-trivial topology, meaning the singularity will have a hole. And if something enters the black hole, it can exit from a place that is called the white hole. A white hole is a hypothetical place, opposite to the black hole. If a black hole is absorbing everything around it, then the white hole is throwing everything that has gone inside of the black hole away, and nothing can enter it.
But what if black hole and white hole would collide?
Additionally, if the black hole had a larger mass than the white hole, then the white hole would just be eaten by the black hole. But if the white hole had a larger mass than the black hole, it could be that the white hole would push the black hole away. Or if the black hole and white hole had the same mass. Actually, we don't know. Remember, a white hole is still a hypothetical place. But one of the most horrifying things that could be inside of it are multiverses.
What does this tell us about whether it is possible to fall in a black hole and come out in another universe? The existence of alternative histories with black holes suggests this might be possible. The hole would need to be large, and if it was rotating, it might have a passage to another universe. But you couldn't come back to our universe. So although I'm keen on spaceflight, I'm not going to try that.
He also suggests that whenever a black hole is formed within our universe, it may lead to the creation of a separate baby universe. And he also wrote a book that is called Black Holes and Baby Universes. This baby universe would only be accessible to an observer who crosses the event horizon of that particular black hole. And thus, we stumble upon universe expansion. The universe is experiencing an expansion, and after the Big Bang, it only keeps extending. The expansion of the universe that is lasting endlessly produces an infinite amount of black holes. It means that in our universe that has existed for over 13.8 billion years, thereafter there should be a tremendous volume of space. We are talking about at least 40 quintillion black holes in our universe, and each of them carries other universes. It means that with an infinite amount of universes, everything that could in principle have happened here did happen somewhere else. But if inside of the black hole has an infinite amount of universes, is our universe inside of a black hole? If black holes in our universe may give birth to other universes, can our existence be a product of another parent universe? It's also logical that if the black holes contain other universes, we can live inside of a black hole. Nikodem Popolowski is a Polish theoretical physicist who shares worldwide his captivating hypothesis that every black hole could be an obsidian veil which may serve as a transcendent portal to another universe. In his model, he suggested that the matter falling into the black hole gets thrown out at the other end and eventually becomes a material for building galaxies as ours. And inside of a black hole, it creates a seed within itself, which has a spin. This seed is thought to have been almost unimaginably tiny, possibly trillions of times smaller than any particle humans have ever been able to observe. As black holes spin very fast, they create a tremendous amount of torsion. Torsion forces the seed to expand rapidly. This process indeed is familiar to the Big Bang, but the only thing is that it happened countless times beyond our imagination. If this theory is true, we are living in a black hole, and all of our existence is just a product of another universe, as well as in another infinite number of universes.